So we live in Wisconsin, which is the frozen tundra. I wanted to find two words that fit together where I could buy a URL that and a phone number that worked. Tundra land made a whole lot of sense. But the best part of the story is me getting the phone number. I decided, what happens if I call 1-800-TUNDRALAND? Who answers? And this plumbing guy in some other state answered, and I said to him, "Hey, you want to sell your phone number?" He says, "Sure." So I have tundraland.com and 1-800-TUNDRALAND. So when I look at when I define what a successful category is, it's obviously what can provide value to our customers and to our company. And a lot of that comes down to the manufacturer who has a great supply chain, who takes care of great training. You know, we're big Jacuzzi Bath Remodel fans, and also Renewal by Anderson. Both of those organizations, it's a great product. It installs well, and customers love it and lasts a lifetime. So I mean, I think if you think about it, what is a P&L? A P&L is an autopsy on your business. You know, a P&L predicts what you hope. A P&L tells you if what you predicted is true. You forecast your business, you think you're gonna do this. A P&L, profit and loss statement, tells you how'd you really do. It's an autopsy. I think everybody in the home improvement industry should look at the relationship and the cost, by the way, between, you know, how many raw leads you get to how many appointments you set. It's in one bucket. The next bucket is how many appointments you set to how many projects you sell. That's another bucket, you know, and both the costs and the relationship between those two numbers. How many projects that you sell to how many to projects you install, and that cycle time between point of sale to point of install. The closer those two dates are next to each other, the more profitable your business is going to be. Some people don't know what are the important numbers to look at. I think sometimes they don't have the right way of tracking it. I think if you're not using a industry-specific CRM and you're trying to do it on Excel or on paper, that's really difficult, and you're actually going to business with one hand tied behind your back, and that's just not a good way to go into a competitive scenario. Yeah, well, you know, we use QuickBooks Pro as a accounting software, but more importantly is the CRM, the customer relationship management software, which is the accounting software is accounting software. Again, in industry specific CRM, we like Improve It 360. We're big fans. It's really a cool program, but there's Market Sharp, and there are others out there that are industry specific and will help you get a long way in your business to track things. Analysis paralysis capabilities. So what I love about Improve 360, first of all, just to get techie for a second, it has an open API, and that means that it can talk to other things inside of our business and other marketing sources and websites. But the other thing is, then we get to be able to we can actually build our own reports. So we can really see, if we really want to look at the business through a different lens, Improve 360, which is a Salesforce platform, allows you to really build it out how you want. We love that. For sure, report building is easy to look at. Their dashboard system is pretty awesome, and I would say I say dashboard and report building. Well, reports get as granular as you want. We don't go there unless if we see a problem in a report. The only time I believe I have to really get granular is, you know, here's what we predict. We're not hitting what we predict. Well, let's really drill down and find out why. So I've got 500 employees inside of my organization, just to be clear, all W-2 employees. And we have multiple businesses that operate under our brands. And at the top of every business is a general manager. And every general manager has P&L responsibility. And that's super important. In fact, once a month, so who gets to see the P&L? Our entire executive leadership team and all the GMs, and then each person inside of the organization gets to see their part of the P&L and how they impact it. Once a month, we do a board meeting. We lay all the P&Ls next to each other as we close out our months, so that every business can see the other business's P&L to see, you know, where are we gaining, where are we losing, and what are the opportunities. And, hey, how did you do that? Oh, wow, how did you do that? It's 1 + 1 = 3, and that's the best way to run a business. I think that, you know, if you think what's the biggest challenge with it is understanding it's garbage in, garbage out, right? So that's the first thing. If it's whatever you put in is what you're gonna get. It's an autopsy. I think a P&L is super important in a business. Most important thing is forecasting with the right KPIs. The P&L just proves that your idea was right, you know, and the P&L, that's all it does. You want your ideas to be right first and foremost. Number one mistake is, well, several mistakes. Number one, they try to give their people inside of their business too many numbers to manage. If you can't run a division with, right, really just looking at two or three numbers, two or three KPIs in the business, you're probably giving that person way too much stuff to look at. That's the first thing. But secondly, I think a lot of times KPIs and targets are established in a silo, in a bubble. It's not up to me to sit in my office and brainstorm what I want all the targets for the business to be, and then have a meeting. This is what everybody's target is. You really want buy-in along the way. So I think the number one mistake people make is they try to build out their business targets in a silo, and then you don't get buy-in all the way along the project, the process. Well, here's what I care about. So, you know, it's interesting. I can run a report in 30 seconds, and I can tell you how many appointments we set, how much we sold. I mean, but I have my manager's report to that all the time. Not because I can't find it. It's because it's important that they know their numbers. And look, if you have a hamburger stand on the corner of a street, at the end of the day, you're going to want to close out your cash register to see how many hamburgers you sold and how much money you made. I think that the divisional leaders must close out their cash register every single day to see how much money they made. And that's a discipline of the organization. I don't need to get into the weeds on every single number. I just want enough information so I know that my leaders are looking at the right things, and then I can coach them up accordingly. I think the understanding that the P&L should never be a surprise to you. The P&L is proof that what you were going to do actually worked. If your P&L is such a big surprise, you're probably not using the right KPIs in your business. You probably don't have the right compensation structure around KPIs, because if you think about that too, you've got, what are the KPIs? In other words, what numbers are the most important thing to your business? And therefore, how do you align compensation with KPIs? When you align compensation with KPIs, your business is truly going to grow. Yeah, what the lever of control that you as a business owner have is you get to decide what you pay for as an activity in your business. You get to determine, we as an organization see this as valuable, and therefore we're going to pay you a bonus on it. You always want to create strong bonus programs around the KPIs in your business that you think are important, which provides, then your employee knows exactly what they're supposed to focus on. People will focus on what they get bonused on because they know everybody thinks that's important. Well, it could be everything from a set rate to a demo rate to a sales rate to an install rate to a cycle time. To me, there are so many different aspects of the business that you can bonus on. You think about, how do you make money in your business? How do you create a better customer journey? And you look at those two things and say, how can I create bonus programs so I can do both of those things a whole lot better? So understand that if you think about business, and especially in the home improvement business, chaos produces revenue. Great, chaos can produce revenue, but discipline produces profits. Okay, so chaos produces revenue, discipline produces profits. Therefore, the best way to increase profitability, number one, is reduce your cycle time from the time it's sold to the time it's installed. That's a super important number. Shrink that lead time down. And also, the way increase profit, reduce loss, is simplify your business. I think the natural tendency in business is to want to grow a business, and we add so much complexity to what we do. And the more complexity you have inside of your organization, the more people you need to manage it, the more systems you have to run it, the more people you need to run the systems, and the more meetings you have to have on it, and it just adds overhead, and it makes it super hard to train anybody in your organization. A business grows by removing complexity from your organization. The simpler you can make your business, the more profitable it's going to be. So if you think about, what business are you in? You're in the people development business, you're in the customer service business, but you're really in the business of forecasting. And not just you as an owner, but your team. Can your team forecast how many appointments they think they can put on the table next month? Can your team forecast what kind of closing average you think they can deliver on? Can your team forecast how many jobs revenue they can install? You wanna always get them to guess. You always want them to forecast, because the better they become at forecasting, and they're gonna learn a lot by being wrong, by the way, but the better they get at forecasting, the more predictable your P&L becomes. That's how those two things really work together, and that's how you grow a monster business. The person that does this will be the hero. Our business is still very fragmented. There's this program for generating appointments. There's this one for doing accounting. There's this one for working up the price. We have a lot of fragmented software pieces that all have to talk to each other. At some point, somebody's going to say, I got one and it does it all and it's super easy to use. Let me teach you how to use it. I think that's the next. We're only first getting started. The home improvement industry is fairly new to technology. And because of that, it's very fragmented. At some point, you're going to start to see that come together, and it's just going to make a huge impact for all of us. It's going to be a big deal.